Metal Gear.
Wait, I should really lean in for that.
Metal Gear.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the show. Last week, we beat Alan Wake's American Nightmare. Get out of there, Twitch window. So this week, I wanted to try something new, and specifically, we're going to try Metal Gear Solid Ground Zeroes. There's an echo, is there? There we go. There. There should not be echoes anymore. Let me know if that's the case. But there shouldn't be anymore. Boy, that must have sounded very different to you. Interesting. Anyway. No, this is still PS3. This is not next gen. I would have gotten PS4, but they didn't have it. I don't think... Is this even out for PS4? I don't know. Yes, more than one Ground Zero. Like I say down here, it'll be Ground Zero times 100. Good, no echo anymore. So this is the prologue slash, I guess, demo for Metal Gear Solid 5. It's like the tanker mission for MGS2, except you had to buy this one separately. So... But I love the Metal Gear series. I'm a huge fan. So as long as I can get past Kiefer Sutherland doing the voice for Big Boss, we'll be great. That's Grounds Zero, I guess. Is it out for PS4 as well? Well, they didn't have it. God, why didn't we get the PS4 version? Strange. Well, anyway, we're here. Yeah, I don't care. I installed it before we started, so we didn't have to sit here for 20 minutes watching it install. I'm drinking water. It's just coming out of a weird bottle. It's a SodaStream bottle, but it's not. It's just plain water. Yeah, that's fine. I don't care about my global rankings. I just want to play this game. Ah, now, so here's the thing. I love the Metal Gear series, and I've played all of the console ones, and I've played the Metal Gear Acid games, which I love, separately for PSP, but I haven't played Peace Walker. So if you'll indulge me for a moment, I'm going to quickly check in on this backstory. There lived a man who was a legend among mercenaries, a man who put together a formidable unit of soldiers of fortune. Long before the advent of private military companies that dared call itself a nation. A man who, with his nation at his back, made an enemy of modern capitalist society in the world. This is his story. Known by codenames such as Snake and later Big Boss, he proved himself as an agent of U.S. Special Forces Unit Fox, but a certain incident spurred him to part ways with the military, and he is said to have roamed the world's war zones as a gun for hire. In 1974, Snake and his partner Kazuhira Miller, or Master Miller, were running a small mercenary outfit in Colombia when they were visited by a man claiming to be a professor from Costa Rica's University for Peace. According to the professor, there have been several incidents involving a mysterious armed group in Costa Rica, a country without a military of its own. The professor was accompanied by one of his students, a girl named Paz, who had been abducted and assaulted by the group. The professor and Paz offered to hire Snake to drive the group out of Costa Rica. However, Snake saw through their deception in an instant. Because he's Snake. Some intense music. The professor was actually a KGB agent. Bum, bum, bum. And the armed group in question backed by the CIA. Was backed by the CIA. Wait. The armed group... Yeah, there is a... That's interesting sentence construction. Anyway, the Cold War was no stranger to such overseas clandestine operations between U.S. and Soviet agents, but the CIA's motives were a mystery. Paz had escaped from one of the CIA's group facilities with a cassette tape. On it was the voice of a woman known as the Mother of Special Forces, the Boss. With a popular song from 1973 playing in the background, it was reasonable to conclude the recording was made recently. Snake was stunned. The Boss was supposed to be dead. What was she doing in Costa Rica? a good point, actually. The boss was Snake's mentor and the only woman he had ever loved, but 10 years prior, Snake was forced to take the boss's life as part of a mission. Spoilers. Also, staggeringly good part of Snake Eater. Snake was unable to turn the professor down. Telling himself he was intervening as a deterrent for a defenseless country, as well as to honor the virtue of Paz's name, peace, Snake departed for Costa Rica. Once there, he ran into a unit of the Sandinista National Liberation Front that had fled Nicaragua. After rising up against the pro-American Somoza regime, these rebels had become targets for the CIA, who killed their commandant and left the unit in shambles. Oh, the art is great. The Metal Gear Solid graphic novels all have this art by Ashley Wood. If I'm remembering correctly, and it's super good. I agree with you, Birds Cannot Fly. I don't like carbonated water at all. Any kind of carbonated water. Snake rescued the Sandinistas and invited them back to Mother Base, the new offshore base of operations provided to them by the KGB. The fallen commandant's children, Amanda and Chico, saw something of their hero Che Guevara in Snake and grew to idolize him. This triggered a rapid expansion of Snake's forces. However, he is still no closer to discovering what the CIA is really up to in Costa Rica. Snake then encountered Hue, a wheelchair-bound scientist being forced to work for the CIA. Hue revealed that the CIA's terrifying plot. They were developing a system by which, following radar detection of an enemy nuclear launch, an AI could analyze all available data and automatically execute a retaliatory nuclear strike at appropriate targets. Although designed to increase the power of nuclear deterrence, Cold Man, the CIA's Central American station chief, planned to actually launch a nuke to demonstrate the effectiveness of automated retaliation. This demonstration was only 5 days away. Snake rushed to the development lab to stop their AI from being completed. Upon infiltrating the lab, Snake was greeted by the voice from the tape, that same voice of his lost mentor, but this was the voice of the AI! Oh my god! Its developer, Dr. Strangelove. I love you, Metal Gear, never change. Had selected the boss, the so-called greatest soldier who ever lived, as the AI's intellectual model. However, succumbing to personal obsession, Strangelove had deviated from the researcher's original purpose. Not only had she reproduced the boss's voice, she was on the verge of bringing her psyche back to life in AI form, driven by a bizarre kind of love. What if the boss could be revived in every detail, if only in AI form? Snake hesitated, as Strangelove's idea touched his sense of loss. His guard down, Snake was immediately captured. Boss's AI was complete, and Peace Walker, the nuclear-equipped walking battle tank, housed this retaliatory AI system, went active. Snake fought in vain as Peace Walker prepared to fire the nuke, but in the face of a catastrophe, it was ultimately a machine that saved mankind from nuclear annihilation. The boss AI sank Peace Walker to the bottom of Lake Nicaragua, stopping the launch. With the crisis behind him, Snake took advantage of his recent mobilization to continue Mother Base's expansion indefinitely. Snake understood the AI had acted to save the world, but did not change the fact that the system based on the boss's mind had just chosen to lay down its weapon. As a weapon himself, Snake felt the act to be a rejection of his life. Undeterred, Snake and Miller invited Doctors Hue and Strangelove to Mother Base to develop Metal Gear Zeke, a bipedal weapon they eventually equipped with a nuclear warhead, suddenly making their unit a nuclear power. This is summarizing Metal Gear Peace Walker, which I have not played. So, meanwhile, Mother Base took in Paz, already an orphan but now left without her KGB benefactor following the end of the crisis. However, this was all engineered by an intelligence agency known as Cypher. Under Cypher's orders, Paz got close to Amanda, Chico, and the others while exploring more and more of the base, secretly plotting to hijack Zeke. Her objective was to use the weapon as a bargaining chip to force Snake into becoming the military arm for Cypher. Paz's attempt failed when Snake defeated Zeke and she was thrown beneath the waters of the Caribbean. It was only then that Snake learned that Chico had fallen in love with her. A diary she kept while on the base was discovered several days later. It revealed a young girl torn between serving Cypher and following her heart. And, with an idea as to Cypher's true identity, Snake could not allow what Chico and Paz knew to fall into their hands. Furthermore, if he could rescue Paz, he might be able to get information from her that would help him fight back against Cypher. On the eve of the nuclear inspection, Snake made the decision to leave for Koopa. Okay, everyone got captured. All right. Let's do it. Actually, wait. Real quick. All right, fine. What, the manual is just a picture of the... Oh. It's just a PDF. Screw it. Verbose mode off. All right. At the end of World War II, the world was split into two, East and West. Neat. Camp Omega maximum security. Super extra bonus security. Oh, Yoji Shinkawa, your designs are so cool. No, Naked Snake is a guy. This is Naked Snake / Big Boss. This is not Solid Snake. Yeah, looks like a gun to me. Uh-huh. Okay, cool. It's a gun. Yeah, drink in those rain effects.
He told us everything.
Huh.
Don't worry. I kept my word. He didn't suffer long. Here. You earned it.
Yeah, I get music. Cranks up. Let the bodies hit the floor here.
How's it feel to play the traitor?
It's not great, mister, if I'm honest.
No more war games. You're a real man now, soldier.
Chico. Was that stuck into his chest? That's weird.
Give my regards to your boss when you get home.
Ennio Morricone, very nice. I give him a potential garrote because he's like 12. Shouldn't be low frame rate. Should be, I mean, we're pushing 30. We should be anyway. Whoops. Even if I was playing the PS4 version, we would only be pushing a 30-frame stream. You can't really do a higher stream.
She survived.
She was rescued by a Belizean fisherman who found her drifting in the Caribbean.
So what's the plan? Silence her before we're compromised?
No. I've got something else in mind. Our friends at Cypress...
Oh, that's Snake talking, of course.
She's being held for interrogation
at
a camp on the southern tip of Cuba.
Black Site. Nice.
That guy.
A slice of American pie on communist soil. And out of U.S. legal.
That is going to get hard to get used to.
The inspection of Mother Base has to be connected somehow. The timing's too perfect.
The U.N.'s nuclear inspection.
My guess is they're trying to corroborate Paz's leak.
We're an army without a nation.
Word of our capabilities gets out, and we'll have the whole world out to shut us down. Having an American private intelligence agency involved is bad news. Cypher's the ones who sent Paz to us in the first place.
She knows the true nature.
Right. Paz is our only link to Cypher. If she's still alive, we need her on our side.
Yeah. David Hayter wanted to do the game, but he found out when they announced that he wouldn't be doing it. He was like, oh. Well, that's handy.
Trojan horse is in.
What's wrong with your face? That's sort of my assumption, the GTF.
This pirate crackdown's a go! Move!
Yes, sir, Commander Skullface, sir. Don't call me that. Don't. Yeah, the camera probably looks shakier to you guys than it is just because of the stream. Once we get into the game, the camera will not be this shaky. Oh, Alcast, have you not played MGS3? Oh, God, you should. Snake Eater is really good. Snake Eater is probably my favorite. How's it going, smooth skin?
So who's the other target?
That would be Chico. He's being held in the same area as Paz. Last radio contact was 40 hours ago. Find them both. Bring them back alive. Enter the compound from the south cliff. Secure Chico and Paz, then report back from the rendezvous point.
Well, patches don't just come off like that. Soft. Why is it Fox backwards? I don't understand. Ah! I'm freaking out. There we go. Free coasters.
We'll from across the Cuban border. You should be back at Mother Base in time for lunch. You'll probably just miss our guests. The only catch is you go in solo. The politically sensitive nature of the mission means backup is not an option.
Fine. I like some alone time now and then.
Of course it's raining. Oh, Tara Strong is in this game. Yeah, this is the PS3 version. I didn't even know you could get it for PS4. Also, they were sold out.
Kept you waiting, huh?
Keith. I mean, go Canada, I guess. There's that. I love Yoji Shinkawa's stuff. Caramel Memo, yes. Alright. Let's do some sneaking. Or no, this isn't tactical espionage action. This is something else. Tactical espionage operations. Funky.
Chico and Paz are being held in an old, unused part of the compound. Get inside and head northeast.
Was he just talking to the audience? He was.
Mission info has been updated.
This is an infiltration mission. You've got to stay out of sight.
Before you go any further, use your binoculars to recon the area. What do you see? Press the call button to get more intel. There's a door in the fence.
I could have told you that.
Your binoculars are equipped with a directional microphone. You should be able to listen in on whatever they're pointed at. Keep low. You can check the controls on the pause screen.
Let's do that. By check the controls, you mean read that thing. All right. Use binoculars, change view, attack, CQC. Why do I have the ability to do that? All right. Primary, secondary weapons, support weapons, items, ready weapon. Oh, it's totally different controls. Ready weapon. Start for your iDroid. Binoculars zoom in and out. Press the L3 button to dash. All right. Change stance, reload, quick dive, and action. This is going to take some... It's going to take some working out.
If you ready your weapon while crawling, you can move horizontally left or right. If you do that holding the dash button, you'll move faster.
Choppers? Who are they with?
These me, man. Green Berets, SEALs.
Those ain't no jarhead birds, I can tell you that. Some paramilitary setup?
Some of the guys are saying. You know what? Best we just drop this, right?
Sure.
What the hell is happening? Neat.
XOF.
That was insane. So I gotta collect all 9 of those patches, and that one you can only get by rolling around a bunch? That is really funny. So what happens if I just straight dome out that light? They probably would get annoyed with me, right? Wait till the light's off me. I have to find all those patches in one mission to unlock the console exclusive mission. Alright.
There's a guard up there. If you're going to eliminate him, use a gun.
Good call. Neat. Guess I'm not going silent this time, am I? Do I even have that option? Ah! Ah! Oh, I do! Well, hell. I prefer tranking everybody, but now I know. Ow. Piff.
Now head east to the old prison area. You can bring up the target's location on your iDroid.
Ooh. Gotta wait for the satellite to come into view. Alright. So, wait, hang on. Okay, so they're over there, where that big light is. Do I need to take out the guy with the light? Probably not. Figured I should get used to that aspect of the game, though. Enemy has left the area. Neat. Ow. Take it to the roof! Oh, that seems like a terrible idea now that I look at it. It'd be way too easy for someone to see me up here. What if I can just dome this guy?
Contact me if you need advice.
I hear an vehicle. Whoops. I assume that's bad. All right. Ow! Not what I meant to do. Can't go inside, apparently. All right. Wow, that guy was looking right at me, huh? No, get down! I'm just gonna hide on the roof here. I like to think that Snake was just like... Hello! Shooting.
Cease fire!
No one has any idea where he is.
CP, this is Zulu 1. No sign of the enemy. Searching the area. Over.
This is CP. Understood. They can't have gotten far. Stay alert. Out.
What are you shooting at? Ninjads, no. This is my first time playing. I mean, I played other Metal Gear games, sure, but this is my first time playing Ground Zeroes. I'm just gonna lie in this puddle in the middle of the roof. I'm assuming they don't check the roofs. Seems like a massive hole in their plan, but... Oh, fudge. No. They've totally foiled my plan. I'm in the shadow. Feel like they shouldn't be able to see me here. The light saw me, so they're all checking the tower with the light in it? Oh, he's looking over there, too. Don't fall backwards.
Zulu 10, what's wrong?
Damn it. See if I can do this. I mean, I hit him.
We have a situation. All units on alert.
46 meter headshot tranquilizer. Boom. They're certainly checking around everywhere that's not me, so that's fine. Well, he's standing down, so I guess that's fine. Shit. Go, 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 go. Get in there, get in there, get in there. Go faster, go faster, go faster. Close the door. Oh, F. Come on.
They'll pack enough power to destroy their anti-air defenses or vehicles.
How come some stuff I have to pick up and...
That rain just won't let up. It'll help you stay out of sight, but watch you don't get hypothermia.
Oh man, that's a thing too, isn't it?
What's up?
Lobbing infinite grenades. Oh, I can only carry one magazine. Oh, shit. I mean, we're fine. Really hauling it over here. You stand around outside and wait, eventually your temperature will drop. Oh, great. Where's he going? He's going underground. Back underground, where they thought it was safe. Okay, why would I want to do that? I came up here to sabotage them. I assume I can, like, blind them somehow. So close. Just go to sleep. Just go to sleep. Just go to sleep. Oh my god, he went to sleep. Alright, I'll take it. Huddle up. Hey-o!
You can move back and forth while hanging. You can also climb back up or let go and drop. Just be sure of your surroundings before you do.
Biff! I'm not used to that move.
You should try listening in on those soldiers. Even casual chatter could reveal something in a place like this.
Oh no, are they being woken up? Sounds like somebody's being woken up. Forty-four meters, eh? No, stop walking. I'm just going to assume he'll go to sleep. Ow! Oh, I can do that? That's a neat thing. No. That's a new trick. Ah! Not what I was trying to do. Whoa, okay, everyone can see me. Yeah, I should try the interrogation. Once I'm not actively being assaulted with bullets. Ow. Really? You can't hide in the porta-potties? They're just shooting at random stuff. Oh, hey. Hey, everybody.
Boss, that's a serious injury. It won't heal on its own. You'll need to treat it with first aid.
By screaming at yourself.
Give me support!
This is a very open area. This is pretty sweet. No, get in there. Get in. No, not there. Apparently I have a first aid spray, so that's fun. Spray this Axe body spray at your chest and grimace. So they have a Zulu unit and they have a Delta unit. Every mountain. I like that you have an option, like, if you get seen, you have an option to, like, try to take him out before they raise an alarm. That's kind of cool. Alright, we may have to go full killing times. That guy is booking it. He is hauling ass. Don't do it. There's someone else nearby, too. Whoa! Really close by. F. Nope. It's not clear. It has a silencer. So many dudes.
Clear.
This is all very unclear. I don't know what you're talking about. Do it. I will end you. Damn it. This is exciting, isn't it? All right. Do I have a flashlight on this thing? How do I turn that off? That's not stealthy. Grenades. That seems bad. That is, yeah. This thing has a flashlight on it.
CP, this is Zulu 10. We're standing down here. No hostile spotted. Over.
Great, now I'm stuck in the middle of this tent city I never wanted to be in the first place. Let me check my iDroid. Well, I mean, I guess I'm getting closer to the place that I do actually need to be. So, I guess we'll deal with that. I'm gonna hold a guy up. No, the D-pad is something else. Oh. Thank you. Thank you. That was very helpful. Stay very still. His outline looks like he skips leg day. Whoop. Where the hell is this guy? I can hear him. I thought he was right here. I am so gonna get spotted. This is not even funny. Alright, there's a guy. Screw it. Yeah, Snake just rips a massive fart. Ow! This barbed wire is useless.
CP, this is Zulu 2. Just saw a suspicious person. Need someone to take a look. Over.
Zulu 2, this is CP. We don't have the manpower right now. Stay on the lookout for further activity. Out.
Really? You don't have the manpower for a guy in your base?
CP, this is Zulu. Marker placed. Just saw a suspicious person. Need someone to take a look. Over.
This is CP. Understood. Sending someone to investigate.
Thank you. Whoa, shiz.
Out.
No. I'm just sitting in the light. From where? What light is this? What is lighting me? I want to kill it. Neat.
Boss, we've been in touch with Amanda. We had her listen to Chico's call for help. She agrees with us. She said, I know my brother and I know when he's lying. She also had a message for you. I'm ready for the worst. Sounded a little too cheerful to me.
Can I just off this guy right here? I'll just tag him.
Take a good look at the enemy through your binoculars, and you can mark him. Marked enemies can be sensed when nearby, even if there's a wall between you and them. But it only works if you stop and take the time to focus your attention. This helps you maintain situational awareness. Try it.
Try it yourself. No, stand up. Because there's another guy over there somewhere. Ah, he's behind the thing. Wank. Is it just those two guys?
All quiet? Hey, did you see those guys' unit patch?
Yeah, Fox, facing right, right?
Right, right.
That's it. You know, it looked just like...
You've seen it before? Where?
Oh, I'm gonna rescue the prisoners, don't you worry.
I know it had a Fox in it, too.
It's just those two. I'm feeling a lot better about this. Must not raise alarm. Eh. Alright, all those guys are way up there. That's fine. What? It's not me.
CP, understood. Sending someone to investigate. Keep your eyes peeled for further activity. Out.
Alright. Shit. It's not subtle, but it works. Yep. You're coming with me. Can I? Oh, I can't throw him over? Alright, well. That surprises me, actually, that I can't throw them over. You're all free!
There's someone in there. What do you plan on doing?
Hi. Wait, I have to carry them? Where do I take them?
Another prisoner. Looks like he's alive.
Thank you. Which one's Chico? That guy. No! I need to rescue the other ones! Oh, there's a drop-off point? Oh. Wait, no, let me get the other people. Oh.
Chico, it's me.
No! No! Go away!
Hey!
Go away!
Right here. Get off, man. Get me out of here, please!
Get off, please. Me! Get off!
Chico, keep it down.
Go away!
Chico, you're just screwing it all up. So did I miss the opportunity to rescue the prisoners by doing that? Chico needs to go to sleep.
Chico.
In a matter of speaking.
Not here.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure.
Is Chico able to walk?
Her shit bucket hasn't been used in a while.
Hold on. Not gonna happen.
That is
carry him out there.
Mean.
Okay, boss, change your plans. Haul Chico over to the rendezvous point. We'll get Posse's whereabouts out of him once he's calmed down.
Mission info has been updated.
Mark the RV on your map. Okay, now carry Chico there.
The map has been updated.
Oh, I see. Alright, so I can just carry all of them? Alright. You come with me. Piss. Ha! Jiggida! Here yet, bucko. I can't use that. Alright, can I?
Those tranquilizer rounds are only good for putting your target to sleep. They won't help you break anything.
Well, that's. Thank you for telling me. Whoa! Where's the safe way down? Good lord. Alright, Snake somehow didn't break his shins doing that, so we're fine. Do I just put him down here? That's it, huh? Okay. We'll take it. Alright, hope everyone's cool with watching me do that a bunch.
Come on.
A POW. That's fine if he has some intel, I guess.
No.
Yoink! Snake does not skip leg day.
It hurts all over.
Now, this is a more direct route. Fump. Somebody know where this is optional. I'm just doing this because I want to rescue all the peoples. Even the guy on the radio was like, I guess you can do that if you want. Snake, figure it out. The rendezvous point was on the edge, it wasn't in the cave. Also, the cave doesn't go anywhere. It's just like an overhang. Bonk. I guess I could have snuck down this way and not had to trank those guys, because they theoretically wouldn't have seen anything. I can put him sort of here, I guess, but I'm just going to keep him all bunched up over here. You need to call the chopper to that point. Well, this is where they told me to go. Alright, I don't know. I'll do that when I get the last guy, and then I'll take Paz, or Chico. Whose name, again, I will remind you, is Chico. Boom! Hey. Yup. That's it, right? There's only four of them? I didn't see anybody else. Last call. All ashore that's going ashore. Yeah, don't stop believing. This is the PS3 version, because I didn't know there were other versions. Sorry. Alright, so now, let's bring up my iDroid here.
Please select a landing zone. Landing zone confirmed.
That's pretty obvious, right? Like, they're gonna see that coming, yeah? Hey! There's my chopper! I assume that's my chopper? No, the only other person is Chico.
This is Morpho, arriving shortly at LZ.
Morpho! So how does this work? Do not land on my prisoners. Don't do it! Good. So what, do I do this? Do I carry them to the... Ah, there we go. So I...
Okay, target is in.
Yep, man. Yep. Why didn't I just call them to the...
Target's inside. Is that it? He's coming too. Roger that.
Yeah, I've got five of them. Chill out, Morpho. So do I just send them off and then go and get Chico and do this again with Chico? Of course they do all the work. They've had bolts put through their hamstrings. So I just send this away? Whatever. Oh, no! Don't get in! Do not get in!
What's wrong, boss? Mission abort?
No! God. Later, Morpho. Alright, well, we'll call Morpho again once I have Chico, I guess. Whatever. Oh, shit. We're fine.
Watch yourself. If you let...
Oh, that's awkward. I hope that saved at some point.
Snake!
Please don't make me run all over there again. Please don't make me run all over there again. Oh. Really? Son of a... Oh. We'll start with Chico. So, fun fact. The action button... Remember, is triangle. And that is not... the button I pushed.
Once you don't end up head first in the ocean. The RV's just a little further.
Probably would have turned it off and returned the game. That's my fault. I pushed the wrong button. Could be better.
Chico, where is Paz?
That's grim.
She's dead.
When was this recorded?
She's dead.
Answer the question.
Droid to call the chopper for pickup.
Marker placed.
Oh.
Marker removed. Please select a landing zone. Landing zone confirmed.
Roger that chopper request. It's headed your way now. Boss. Chico's tape probably contains some clues.
I'm gonna go get another guy.
Select it on your iDroid to listen to it.
And then I'm gonna see if I can call the chopper to here. Or somewhere closer for the rest of these guys.
You can pull them out too if you want, but just don't forget the targets.
Figure I had time to get at least one of them before the chopper showed up. Yeah, Morpho, haul your butt. Let's call a different chopper.
This is Morpho, on station at LZ.
Wait, sadly you can't? I'm not aborting crap, dude. I'm just replaying a bunch of crap that I shouldn't have to replay it because I'm an idiot and pushed the wrong button. I pushed the fall snake into the ocean button. Because I'm dumb. Instead of the maybe don't be a scrub button and climb back up. Later.
Okay, target is in.
Morpho, you... whatever, I'll just call him again when I get the other two down there. I'm like, alright, here's a random dude. Morpho's like, alright, later. I got places to be, man. There's a game on tonight. What, did you need me for something? Yes, you chump. Morpho, you colossal idiot. Who keeps closing that gate? Whoever it is, they need to cool it. Presumably, I will get another checkpoint once I save Chico. A phone? How about I get you out of here first? Then we start talking about, you know, niceties. Bum 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 bum. Bum bum bum. No, don't, yeah, there you go. Get in there.
Another prisoner. Looks like he's alive.
The ghost of all the people Big Boss has killed.
No.
I'm glad I found a more direct route.
It
probably hurts like hell. And does it hurt all over or just in the ankles? It's probably wet all over. Yeah, it probably hurts all over. Glad I can work this. Glad I can work the iDroid while I'm carrying a guy. The lone bard says, "I assume it's a guard who keeps coming back to check on the prisoners." Going, didn't we used to have more of these? Hey, who keeps leaving the door open? Yeah, I have not played Peace Walker, and there was a briefing at the beginning, and it told me everything I needed to know. Morpho! Get in! Get in, Morpho! Hurry up.
This is Morpho, arriving shortly at LZ.
Yeah, well, you should never have left the LZ, Morpho. See you on station. Are you ready to receive prisoner of war ingest? The target can wait his turn.
Target's inside. Is that it?
What are you, blind?
He's coming too. Roger that.
Yeah, we're having a party. The party shouldn't involve too much dancing.
Okay, target is in. Chico's tape. Think it could give us a clue to Paz's location? Use your iDroid to listen to it.
Later. I kept walking on Chico because he's in the way. Looks like I can shimmy around though. But.
I hear vehicles.
Fair enough.
Must be near the heliport.
This is a terrible recording, Chico. You're bad at this. Miller's really good at this. Wasn't sounding bad initially.
Chico left the tape on record while he was being moved. Try using what you hear to find Paz. If you're still not sure, listen to the tape again.
Oh, that guy just drove the truck away. Sweet. How do I interact with this guy?
CQC is effective for dealing with nearby enemies.
Oh, come on. I was trying to get him to talk, but I didn't know what the talk button was. Oh, well, whatever. No. Give me back my silence gun. I just wanted to pick up this guy. Turns out it was L2. By the way. We're fine. I'm going to... That guy's still sitting in his truck. Oh, it's still moving. All right. I'm going to get rid of every single one of the lights on this place.
Still searching for Paz? Try interrogating some of the Marines. They must know something.
Oh, there we go.
Open the front gate. Supply deliveries on its way in.
To interrogate an enemy, first grab him.
Okay.
Now either interrogate him, knock him out, or kill him. His life is in your hands.
Spit it out.
Spit it out.
Spit it out. Speak.
Huh. Interesting. What the? What the? I was knocking this guy out. What the hell was that? That is bull crap. Alright. It's weird that the guards don't have voice acting for that. If I have to carry a bunch of prisoners again, I'm gonna start throwing controllers.
Now let's find Paz.
Good.
If she's dead, we need to see the body to be sure. Boss, any clue where she might be?
Like that he faded in and then a guy faded in on top of him. That was entertaining. Whoa. You tap R1 until he's automatically dropped. All right. Well, now I know. Where's the driver of that thing? Wait, why did it say time paradox? Because you know from future games that boss doesn't die here.
You can now either interrogate.
No!
His life is in your hands.
Sure. Ow. You can get in the car? Well, hell. Yoink! This doesn't seem like the most subtle plan.
The surveillance camera.
Shit! Oh, I really thought that would explode. What? Why did you knock me out of that? No, I wanted to use the artillery. I love that I got a counter for how far I threw that guy. That was pretty awesome.
Now let's find Paz. If she's dead, we need to see the body to be sure.
Wait, I'm over here now.
Clue where she might be.
So is my truck. Neat. Oh shit. Nope, nothing, nope. Yeah, like a sack of potatoes. I actually don't know where she could be. Where am I going? I gotta try and interrogate some more dudes. There's a lot of dudes over here. Boss, what happened? Did you randomly get into a truck and expect that nobody would see you? Yes. There's a tank! Oh, that's happening. Nobody saw that. Damn. I don't know why I thought that would work. You're way too exposed. You idiot. Okay, this is fairly exposed. To be fair. A lot of guys. Ooh. Nope. Nothing. Nothing. Nothing at all. See any way this could go badly. What the? Okay, so I do have to hold that down. God damn it.
Speak.
The map has been updated.
Neat. Alright, we got there. In that, I figured out how to use that particular control. I will be looking at the turret momentarily. Trust me. Alright. Step one. Wait, what? Alright. Do you think they'll notice I'm here? Wait, really? Okay, good. No fix on the position. They still don't know where I am, which is curious. Did I get away with that? Stealth!
What the hell?
So your suppressor is worn out. That gun will be as loud as any other now. If you have to shoot, be careful.
Balls. There are guards coming after you? Well, they're taking their sweet time. I believe that worked. Can't tell if I hit him or not. I didn't hit him.
CP, this is Zulu 6. Still no hostiles around here. We're standing down.
Ha! They're standing down! Oh, there we go. It just takes a while to hit him.
Return to your boat. Out.
Oh, yes. It's so good. Yoink. No. Great. I got more trank rounds. I was trying for headshots. Come on. Alright, well, didn't get to interrogate anybody, but we sort of depopulated a large portion of the area. So that was exciting.
Surveillance camera.
Where? You can tell me these things, but it doesn't. Oh. Man, old school. I guess there's also that, yeah.
CP, this is Delta 6. Gunfire. No fix on the position. Over. This is CP. Understood. All units, be on alert.
Resuming normal patrol. Because no one can come look for it, because everyone is dead. All right, well. It's a good thing Boss is a master of stealth. Now then. I have to do more stealth.
You can fire its weapon too. Check the pause screen for details.
Attack with the vehicle's weapon if it has one. All right. I'm being stealthy. Hello. Cannot aim this. There's no. Getting out of here. Oh, them old Duke boys got themselves in a mess of trouble the day they stole the tank. No, if I run them over, that means I have to get close to them, and then they will know where I am. The only reason I've gotten away with it so far is because they can't see me. fire randomly. Go for it. You all saw that, right? Oh my god. They can't clear the room now because the guy in front died. That was amazing. They're all forming up over there. I'm gonna peace out. Clear. Damn it. Well, that may not have worked. Alright. That was amazing. Oh, okay, they found me. Oh, there's a lot of guys. Just get up, Snake, get up. Don't. No, okay. Wow.
What happened?
I hope somebody was able to capture that for posterity. That was pretty astonishing. He's just like, no, I'm nothing. Alright, how many of them are dead? Is this after I messed with the turret? Yeah, it looks like it. Neat. Oh, and the security camera, so that's cool. That was amazing. Like, I just wasn't in his vision cone.
That's the admin building. Watch your corners.
Watch your own corner. You watch your corners, corner man. To hold him up. I just meant to hold him up. Oh well. I pushed this and I pushed them both at the same time. Oh shit. Wow, I can't believe that camera didn't work. That guy definitely saw my shadow or something. Yeah, I lost my suppressor. Neat, he shows me where the guys are. That's cool.
CP, this is Delta 6. We got a body here. Be on the lookout for intruders. Over.
This is CP. Understood. Further losses are unacceptable. Keep your eyes open.
Unacceptable! Whoops.
has been updated.
A sniper rifle, you say? You should explore the underground area. Is that not where I am? Oh, he's a shotgun. That's neat. Or is that over here? Hey, wait. Where's that sniper rifle? Truck.
CP, there's a solo one.
Huh.
Still no hostiles around here.
That's not close by.
Over.
This is CP. Understood. All fire team.
Yeah, we're just gonna stand down. Oh. Well, hey. That seems like relevant. Mad snipes, bro. Get some kills for your montage. Yeah! Gotta no-scope him. She's had some issues. A double agent.
Boss,
get Boss onto the helicopter.
Wait, Marine's shift change. Does that mean they're all the guys I killed are back now? All the unconscious guys traded out their shift for the... I guess since they're all being woken up by the new shift, that's what's going on. This is probably bad. Stop sucking me. God, shoot him in the thing. Right, have to use the pistol. Why do they keep telling me to get out of here? It's like, I'd love to. Can you just let me through? So where's the closest LZ?
Please select a landing zone.
Oh, there's one. It's the same one. Great. Contact with who? Paz, you're not being very quiet. Paz, are you hurt? Kill you. Guy. Fuck. Later. Ooh, rough. Well, I'm okay.
Target confirmed dead.
Target confirmed super deceased. Wow, I need to take a break. We get some more water and go to the bathroom. And then we will escape with Paz, and then I guess that's it. Unless there's more. But then if there isn't, then I'm just gonna dink around in the sandbox and drive a tank around, basically. Alright, but actually the bathroom. Nope, that is not paused. There we go. Actual bathroom break. Alright, I'll be right back. Sit tight. Do 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 do. Bwomp. Bump 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 bump. Boop boop boop. Boodly boop. This chair is high. Yar. Etc. Simpsons quotes. Says I. Alright. Right. I only have 7 bullet. Need more bullet. Oh yeah, the unit patches. Sorry, Paz. What the? No. Engage with an enemy force. We're getting married in the spring. Oh, good range on that. Well, if I'd known, I could have just done that the whole time.
Drop on you. Keep your guard up. Out.
Sorry, Paz. There he is. I was like, I hear a guy really close by. Hey, where am I going? Oh, back to the same landing zone as before. Oh, it doesn't seem that bad. Security cameras up.
CP, there's a solo one. Search complete. No sign of hostiles. Over.
This is CP. Understood. Stay alert. Don't let him get the drop on you. Out.
Yeah, all the complaints, just to what some of you are talking about in chat, all the complaints of, oh, there's claymores here too? That I've seen about the game, about this, you know, is that it's, because it is only a prologue or whatever, is that it's, you know, it's, you're paying for a demo. I don't know. I bought it. I guess I don't know, like it's...
The drainage channel. You might be able to crawl in there.
Not with Paz. Like, it's... I don't know. On the one hand, it's a cop-out for me to just be like, well, don't buy it. On the other hand, I don't know. No one got this bent out of shape with Gran Turismo 5 Prologue, which they sold as its own independent game, and people bought. At full price, no less. So, I don't know. Yeah, I'm just looking forward to doing a lot of repeated playthroughs of this and messing around. Probably not on stream, because I don't know if you guys just want to watch me repeatedly dink around with the game. Maybe you do. I'll be doing some of it tonight, assuredly. Let me just wait till this thing is finished saving, because I think I'm checkpointing here. And I just opened the door. Great.
Go ahead and call the chopper. Keep an eye out for nearby enemies. They can try to shoot down the chopper.
Babes, in the mine.
I can call the chopper right here?
Please select a landing zone.
Oh. Alright. Danger high. What if I destroy these AA guns, huh? Whatever. I've basically killed everyone nearby.
Stand down! Stand down! Return to your
boat! Boss, are you sure about this?
Listen, Magno. Morpo. Morphy Dorphy. Go to sleep! There you go. Go to sleep. Yeah, it's not, I mean, it's not full price, also. For whatever that counts, it's a little over half of full price, actually. This was $40. And I plan on milking $40 worth of enjoyment out of this. I'm already having a blast. But I bought a new game for Unskippable today. It was $70. That's brand new. And it wasn't even a AAA title.
So,
I don't know. Come on, Morpo, or whatever the hell your name is. Yeah, I know, Jaded Cynic, I know. $40 Canadian. Guys. They charge us more up here.
Put the target on the chopper.
What games are $70 new? Games that are in Canada in Canadian dollars. They're charging 20 US on PlayStation Network. So that's a little bit more reasonable as far as I'm concerned.
He says he knows the location of a unit patch. I don't know what he's talking about, but I've marked the location on your map anyway.
The map has been updated.
Oh. If I got on the chopper, then I'd be done and have to go home. Now I'm playing. Armory. So that's an armory. So you can't just say $70 is $63, or $70 Canadian is $63 US. It's not exchange rates. It doesn't work like that. We just get charged more for video games. Not as bad as Australians or New Zealanders, but it's not. You can't just be like, oh, the exchange rate is this, so is that. No. A new game, because they just jacked the prices up, a new game is $70. And you just have to deal with it relative to other Canadian costs. So. Alright, where are we going here? What's this? Ammo. Non-lethal. Oh, I like that. Where am I, though? Alright.
Marker placed.
Ooh, there's a unit.
Marker
patch.
Placed.
Unit patch. Wait, on the roof? It is on the roof.
Another unit patch. Could it be more of it?
There could be. I don't know what that would do. Oh. Bring my iDroid here.
Marker placed.
I think I've done the mission, basically. Now I'm just going to go depopulate this island. Sweet. I don't see this going badly. Maybe I should look at the road. I'll play around with the trucks later. Yes, more tranks. Excellent. Now, what else have I been told? More non-lethal ammo.
Marker placed.
Unit patch. Let's go. Actually, I can drive there. beep, beep, I'm a Jeep. It's up there.
Good. You've completed the objective. Now get out of there.
Yeah, but no. Oh yeah, the sniper rifle. I mean, it makes sense that there'd be one of these patches. How do the guards know where these patches are? Makes sense there'd be one here. So this unlocks a mission, not in this, but it unlocks a mission in the full game. When's that coming out, by the way? The Phantom Panya. The Phantom Bread. I did stalk for soldiers. Thank you for noticing. You are gonna get interrogated. You are gonna get so interrogated, it's not even funny. Oh, there's more missions in this? Oh.
CP, this is Zulu 6. Just saw a suspicious person. Gotta check it out.
I thought that was the whole mission.
CP, understood. Keep your guard up. Out.
Well, I'm gonna get all the patches then. Good thing I can hear their radio.
Speak.
The map has been updated.
I am finishing the mission, but before I finish the mission, I'm getting all the patches, because you have to collect the patches in this mission. So I've done all the hard stuff, and now I just have to go looking around for patches. I was hoping that guy would tell me where more patches were, but I think that's all the ones I've been told about. That's me. That's ammo. That's ammo. That's the sniper rifle. Definitely getting that. That's the armory. Those are the surveillance cameras. Yeah, that's all I've been told about. Alright. Just got to go look. Whoa! Alright. Yeah, I think call them makes them call off the... Uh-oh. On the roof there. I don't know how I'm gonna get that.
CP, this is Zulu 2. We're all done here. No sign of any intruder. Returning to posts. Over.
CP, understood. Return to your posts ASAP. Out.
Okay. crap. Hey, Kathleen.
Food.
Food?
I brought you dinner.
I love food. It's one of my favorite things.
Forever.
You want to come in? Thanks everybody answering PS3. Didn't know you could get it for PS4. Just dome them out. Oh, this is fantastic.
I decided I would not duck because I'm lazy. I just made a boop noise.
That's okay, I do that a lot.
Hi, everybody.
Ooh. Nothing at all. Kathleen, bring enough for everyone. I don't know. You may have only brought enough for me.
I did not even bring enough for myself. I haven't actually eaten dinner yet.
Oh, no.
Well, because it was either cook pork chops, eat a pork chop, bring you a cold pork chop, excuse me, and cold vegetables.
Get a cassette tape, eh? Interesting. Well, I appreciate it.
There you go again.
How dare you?
Or cook your food, or like cook vegetables. Set mine aside, cook your food, and then bring you a pork chop while it was still warm.
Hmm.
So I decided I would err on the side of bringing you a pork chop while it was still warm.
I am in favor of that. To that end, I'm going to eat this pork chop momentarily. I'm trying to figure out how to get up on this thing.
Also, ack. Oh, there's just pork chop juice on this.
Cassette tapes of what? Duran?
Oh, excellent, Dalasar. The Lone Bard, I don't really use pasta, so you can have all that lasagna to yourself.
I think I just crushed a rat by diving on it. A little unclear on how I managed that, but here we are. I'm gonna get up to the top of this tower so that you can see the base. And I'm gonna start putting pork chop in my face.
And it's asparagus and spaghetti squash with butter and salt.
Nice. So there's another mission in the, other than this one, in addition to the secret unlock that I'm trying to get here? That's good, because it didn't feel like there was, so I'm pretty happy about that.
Chico made that tape for Cassandra, and now you are ruining his chances at romance, Graham.
Holy crap. This looks amazing.
I wish we could show the chat. Wait, flip it over. I think the other side is seared better. Oh, it totally is.
Pork chop. It looks a little blown out on camera, but here we are.
And then asparagus and spaghetti squash. Oh, the asparagus is being keyed out. But I assure you, it's delicious bright green.
Oh,
There's like five other missions. Oh, man.
How's the pork chop?
It's really good.
Is it dry?
No.
Oh, thank God.
Without being rude, I'm going to eat it very quickly so that I can continue doing this. Oh, yeah. Let's listen to the tape while we eat. This can't possibly go badly.
So chat while Graham is. Well, I guess
no, there's a thing playing. There's something playing anyway. Not a lot going on yet.
Don't touch me, you son of a bitch!
Oh, this is lovely dinner music.
Is it actually a mixtape?
No. It's someone being probably assaulted.
Oh. Well, that just makes me feel bad.
Oh. You're not listening to it.
Weak. We need her alive. Yes, sir.
Buzz.
Huh?
You're back early today.
Early?
And the sun is still up. I came here to...
Just quiet. Or I'll scream.
What the... I don't get it.
Well, that was exciting, wasn't it?
Apparently the, for reading the chat, I don't have headphones on. See, no headphones, so I didn't hear it, but it sounded really bad.
Yeah. To be clear, she was being tortured. I do not believe that was meant to imply sexual assault, for whatever that matters to anybody in the chat. I think what I'm saying is please stop using the phrase rape tape. I would appreciate that.
That sounds uncomfortable.
This pork chop, on the other hand, is fantastic.
I'll give the chat... To lighten the mood, I'll give the chat my recipe for juicy pork chops.
Ooh, bonus.
So, pork chops are great because they are a very cheap meat. You can buy them. They don't cost a lot of money. You feel good because, you know, you can get two of them for like $5 or even less sometimes. But the problem with pork is you gotta cook it well. Like, that whole, like, pork trichinosis thing is, you know, like, undercooked pork is not gonna kill you, but of course you don't want it raw. And with a pork chop, you want it like crispy and brown on the outside, but then you want it cooked all the way through on the inside. So how do you accomplish that? Well, quite simply. First, what you do.
You know that you're not in shot, so it's just like, it looks like I'm playing Metal Gear while listening to like a cooking cassette. Which is fine.
I don't want to be in shot.
Okay, you don't have to be in shot.
Take pork chops, add juice. No, you don't need any juice to them.
Juice? Interesting.
You can brine your pork chops ahead of time, which is basically just soaking them in salt water for like 3 hours. That'll make them more juicy and like seasoned, and you can add other like seasonings to the bribe. But say you're a regular person and you haven't thought ahead to buy pork chops the day before, prepare a brine, but you know, sometime in the afternoon so you can make dinner or the night before. You know, let's say you're a real person. So what do you do to make a good pork chop? First, get a pan and get throw some olive oil in there and turn your heat on to medium and let it get real hot. While you're doing that, take the pork chops out of the fridge. Ideally, you would have taken them out of the fridge like 10 minutes ago so they're not ice cold. Cooking fridge temperature meat is a really good way to get tough meat. And you're not going to get food poisoning if you let your meat warm up for like 10, 15, 20 minutes. So there's a cooking pro tip, but we'll just say that you've taken them right out of the fridge because you were just like, I need food. And put them out on a plate and pat them and dry them off because they're covered in all sorts of, like, you know, meat slime, basically. That makes it sound grosser than it is. It's just moisture from the meat, condensation from being in a fridge and stuff like that. So dry them off and then season them nicely with salt and pepper. Or you can season them with other things, but salt and pepper is really good. You want the natural, delicious flavor of the pork to shine through. Alright, so, anyhow, then you take your pork chop, and you remember that smoking hot pan, like, almost probably literally at this point? Then you drop it in there, and I'm recommending extra virgin olive oil, all of you guys, not butter for this. And your pork chop's gonna be like, you get all, like, sizzly and stuff like that. That's perfect. And basically, leave it alone. Leave it alone for 3 to 5 minutes. It's delicious. They'll get that sort of delicious crispy brownness built up. And then eventually after 3 to 5 minutes, you know, check the brownness, make sure it's not burning. Feel free to skip to step ahead, but at medium high heat it should be fine. Take your pork chop and use it to something like that. Flip it over and then lower the heat. And then grab a piece of tin foil if you have a big pan, or like a pot lid if you have a small pan, and then cover it up. And like lower the heat to like 2 or 3, and then cover that mofo for a good long time until your meat is cooked appropriately, which depending on, you know, how thick your... I'm not going to give you exact times because it depends on how thick your pork chop is and all of that stuff. Basically, you want the juices to be running clear. You can check with a meat thermometer, it should be 140, but it might be hard to get an accurate reading because pork chops aren't very thick. But basically, if you do what I do, is just make a little experimental slit, and it looks mostly cooked all the way through. Like, it can be a very light pink, but obviously not, like, raw meat pink. So.
How many times have I knocked out Zulu 10? Sorry.
That's alright.
Sorry, the chat's paying attention.
Alright. And anyhow, so. After that, put on a plate, cover it with your pot lid again, or some tinfoil or something like that, and let it sit in its own, like, cooking juices for, like, 3 to 5 minutes, and that will keep it extra juicy and tender. And basically, that should keep it, and then when you finally serve it, it will be warm. This was warm, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah.
And I wrapped it in tinfoil and took it and, like, walked it over to the moon base. By the time you serve it, it'll go from being that sort of light pink to the perfectly white cooked all the way through. But because you will have, like, set it in, you know, let it sit in its own juices and stuff like that, and kept all the steam and stuff, and it should be nice and tender and delicious. Unlike steak, it can't be reddish in the middle. No, you don't want to serve a rare pork, but because you are letting it continue to cook in its own, like, heat and juices, it does not have to be pure white when you take it out of the pan, right? You can let it do that step itself. Like, cooking pork for too long is a good way to make it taste dry.
How did he see me?
Understood. Make your check, but proceed with caution. Out.
So anyhow, that's pork chops. What veggies do I pair with pork?
Green's green.
Whatever. Tonight it was asparagus because it was on sale, and the squash because it was also on sale. I base a lot of my vegetable choices on whether or not they are on sale.
That's fair.
Now, say you want to impress a date. That's a reasonable assumption, right, Graham? You got a hot lady or guy coming over. You know. So, you got a date, you want to impress them. Do the first part of the searing, and then when you go to flip it, and turn down the heat to cover it.
Damn it.
Take a few thin-ish, but not like razor thin, slices of apple, and put it on top of the pork chop. And then do all the rest. And then when you're ready to do the when you take it out, the apple will be nice and cooked and like mushy and sort of like have like apple juice will sort of soak into the pork chop a bit, it'll be really good. Whatever kind of apple you want to use is fine. I don't recommend Red Delicious, they turn really like mealy when you cook them, but other than that, whatever's on sale. Then when you're doing that like letting it rest period, then the piece de resistance. You put a little slice of green cheese on there. And then, of course, when you take, you know, your cover off, you don't want it to be, like, firm on top, obviously, because cheese will get that stuff. But you have beautifully cooked, juicy tartar covered with, you know, nicely cooked, like, pieces of apple, which are, you know, pork and apple goes together real well. Delicious. And then a melty piece of green cheese. How can you go wrong? Put a little pepper on top of the green. Oh my god, your date. Think that you were amazing.
There's a lot of bullets happening.
Is this game hard?
As with all Metal Gear games, to get not seen is very hard. Thank you for the cooking tips, Kathleen. It sounds delicious.
Not blue cheese. Free cheese. Caramelized onions are also good, but this you could caramelized onions you need to make in their own pan. You can make all of this in one pan, so you can impress somebody, and it's easy to do. And when I say thin slices of apples, I don't mean like cut your apple into eight. I mean cut your apple into like, I don't know.
I just domed out that rat.
Like that thick, I guess? It's hard to say. Like too, you don't want them too thin. You don't want them too thick, otherwise they won't cook.
I got nothing from the rat.
What were you expecting to get from a rat?
I don't know. In Resident Evil 4, you get stuff. I mean, not a lot of stuff, but you get stuff.
You could do pears, but pears don't cook as well as apples. And then you're not getting the traditional apple and pork chop, right? Like pork chops and applesauce? Mom used to make, but my mom did not make that. I did not say blue cheese.
No, you said brie. Alright. Where are they? Whoa, they're all up on the roof.
Just throw them.
Wait, down. There's all of them on the roof?
Throw a grenade up there. Problem solved. Oh, quince is good. Quince is like a cross between an apple and a pear, but good luck finding quince.
Damn, they're still on alert. No point hanging around. Get your ass out of there.
Zulu 2, what's wrong? Come in, Zulu 2!
You just straight scoping them?
I'm just putting them to sleep.
Are they going to sleep?
Kinda. Huh? That is funny.
One's coming down.
That's fine. Well, I guess I can try a different gun if my silencer's broken. No. I don't want to pick up the guy. While I have him, I may as well ditch him in the alleyway. But... Well, he didn't fall off the roof, he just fell asleep on the roof. I gotta find enough guys to tell me about the rest of these fox tags. I can't believe that you just get to completely smear rats to death by diving on them like that.
Snakes always had a mullet, guys.
Yeah.
The snake haircut. Kathleen, any suggestions for a chickpea-based salad? Actually, here's a good salad. It's not chickpea-based salad, but here's what you can do. If you've got a bunch of chickpeas. Chickpeas are delicious. I don't cook with them very often because I don't do a lot of carbs. I just get fat. I get bloated. Come from a bloated family. Diabetes rampant in my bloodline. But here's a nice thing that you can do. Take chickpeas or white beans and take some asparagus. If they're canned chickpeas, I assume random rinse them, that kind of thing. Formidable. Take some asparagus and cook it until it is tender crisp. Then let it cool down. Once it's cold, throw it in a bowl with your chickpeas, toss them with some good olive oil and some good salt. And so you have like a ratio of like 2 asparagus to 1 chickpea, so maybe not the entire can of chickpeas if you're using a head of asparagus. So you've got this kind of, and I would chop up the asparagus into like we like 1-inch chunks like that. So you got like this melange of chickpeas. Now poach an egg, which is easy to do because you can buy commercial egg poachers. If not, it's a good skill to learn. It's not that hard, you just need some water and some vinegar. A little like a teaspoon of vinegar in your water, and you won't taste it, but it'll help your egg poach. And then once your egg is poached, then you drop it on top of your salad. Oh, salt and pepper, by the way. Truffle salt, if you're feeling really fancy, really good. And then you have a chickpea and asparagus and poached egg salad, and it's amazing.
All right, this guy is getting interrogated.
I've made that for you before. Agree? Tasty?
Yes, fact. Tell me where more of the patches are. I know where the anti-air emplacements are.
It says it updated your map info, so maybe you didn't. Does he stay knocked out forever?
Until someone wakes him up, yeah.
What if you trank him?
Then he goes to sleep. Until somebody wakes him up.
Note to self, don't let Kathleen cook for me? Why not?
Yeah, it's tasty. It's all super tasty. I don't know, maybe they're lactose intolerant or something? Or gluten? Or,
I've not listed anything with gluten or lactose in it. Oh, and I guess the cheese. Well, that recipe I literally just gave you, Kid Spanner, was a vegetarian recipe. You can't go wrong with a quiche.
Quiche is good stuff.
Wanda June, if you're not into the poached egg, I wouldn't bother making that recipe because the poached egg really makes it. And
I really... Shh. We're fine.
The poached egg is really easy if you buy an egg poacher, and they're like dollar store things. They're little silicone cups, basically. Oh, you have texture issues with anything less than totally hard-cooked egg. Well, you know what? The egg, as weird as this is going to sound to you, the white is cooked. But the yolk, because it is not hard-cooked, it'll be a little soft, acts as like a delicious dressing, basically, for the salad. That sounds... if it sounds gross, I don't know, try it once. I'm a firm believer in trying things that you don't like when you get older because you find that your tastes change.
Haha! Sniper rifle. Whoops.
Quiche is delicious and easy to make. What are some other good vegetarian recipes I know? Oh, I know lots.
Wait, there's a guy in that tank? That's bad. Da-da-da.
He saw you.
Shit.
So what if they're chicken menstruation? Eat them. They're delicious. Good for you. High in protein. Isuka 990, I totally missed what you said you don't want me to cook for you. But I'm a little offended. Not like actually offended, but I seriously want to know. Hard boiled egg is good, but it's not the same. Yeah, there's lots of good recipes for like a chickpea salad. You can toss chickpeas and avocado.
No, Angel of Dust, one of the guards did tell me where a patch was. Sorry, I just wanted to respond to one of the questions about the game.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Chickpeas, avocado, like a nice like cherry tomato or a Campari tomato. That would be a really good salad. Maybe some cucumber or something like that. You probably don't even need it. What else can you do in there? Chickpeas, Campari tomatoes. Avocado, some lime juice. That would be a really tasty salad mixed together.
What? I thought I misclicked, but I got him. He just said this here. He didn't tell me what it was. Good night, Night Valian.
I mostly don't do chickpeas, so.
Did he just say we are here, the warehouse area? Was he just telling me where we were? Alright. Alright, in the interest of me accomplishing something, I am more than happy for people to tell me where the unit patches are.
Quentin Dreaming says, I pretty much like all food, plus or minus tiny preferences. I'm extraordinarily grateful for this. I'm a firm believer in trying everything, even if you don't think you'll like it. Because you never know what you'll like. Just go into everything with an open mind. And sometimes not liking foods is not actually disliking the foods, it's disliking how they're prepared. Like, for years I thought I hated potatoes because the only way I got them was, like, boiled. Not even boiled. They were like microwave served with salt. They're the worst things in the universe. I still don't like potatoes very much, but there are good ways to prepare them. Apparently, when I come to your stream, I just blather.
Did someone say that?
No, that's me saying that.
Oh.
Mason Rao says, I didn't know this was a cooking channel. Love it. Thanks, Kathleen. Alright, somebody give me a challenge here. Give me three ingredients you have on hand, and I'm not talking ramen
noodles. South side of the refugee camp. Where? Oh, I see. I'm looking at the wrong thing. Oh, man. I was already there. All right.
Somebody from the chat. I'll take the first one I see. Three things you happen to have on hand, and I don't mean mustard and ramen noodles. I mean, like, three things that you could count as food. Like, you know, half an old cabbage, some onion, you know, a couple of these things. And I will assume you have things like olive oil, salt, pepper, basic seasoning, or at least the ability to go to the store and buy one ingredient, and I will attempt to solve your food problems. And no Hot Pockets. Oh. Bacon, squash, and russet potatoes? Chicken breast, pepper, and spinach?
Bacon, squash, and russet potatoes sounds too easy.
Yeah, no kidding.
It's also weird that you're talking from off camera.
All I have is mustard and ramen. All of these things have scrolled off. So. Bacon, lettuce, and tomato. Just make a BLT. Problem solved. Alright. The GTF. He says a ham steak, a packet. No. Never mind. Sweet peas, whole kernel. Hot dogs coming up a lot, actually.
Well, everyone has hot dogs lying around.
Really? Yeah. We never have hot dogs.
It's because we don't have hot dogs. You've told me nothing!
That guy knows when to shut up. Apparently. Alright. What was it? It was like... Darn it. I haven't eaten dinner. Udon noodles, chicken, and a half an old cabbage. Oh, if you have udon noodles, chicken, and half an old cabbage, you can make homemade sukiyaki. Or not sukiyaki. What is the noodle dish? The Japanese noodle dish. Cook your udon noodles, like, and then get up, and then cook your... So, like, they're cooked, right? Take them out of the package and cook them and stuff like that. Then take them, then once they're done and sort of broken up, drain them, set them to the side. And then cook your chicken in a pan. If you have any onion, throw that in. That could be
good.
Once your chicken is done.
Boom!
Throw in some thinly sliced cabbage, like really thin, and your udon noodles. And your udon noodles are cooked, so all you need to do is warm it up. You don't want to cook this for too long, so and then toss in some soy sauce and some mirin if you have it, but that's ridiculous, so we'll just assume you don't have it. But cook it, toss in some soy sauce, and cook your chicken in some olive oil. And so then all the delicious sort of like chicken cooking brown bits on the bottom of your pan and the flavor of the chicken and like the grease from cooking the chicken will get all over your cabbage and will get all over your udon noodles and sort of like mix it together get all the flavors together. If you have onions, that would be good to throw in there, and you can make homemade food. That is yakisoba. That is what I'm thinking of. So what was the person who had... It was hot dogs and two other things.
Come here, rat. I'm gonna dive on you. Boom, got there. Okay. Aha.
Hot dogs, canned peaches, and pasta. Alright, we're throwing out the canned peaches. The canned peaches, just drain them and eat them for dessert. Right? Hopefully they're not canned in syrup and they're just canned in juice. Because those three things don't really go together. So you have noodles and you have hot dogs. Do you have... That's hard. Alright, but no, you know what, we'll deal with this.
Noodles and hot dogs is easy.
Alright, but we're not gonna go mac and cheese and hot dogs here. We're gonna do something slightly different. We're gonna make pretty weird Italian pasta. Cook some noodles. And then once your noodles are cooked, in, or while they're cooking, I guess, in a pan, get lots of butter together, like some brown butter, like make like sort of like brown butter is where you take butter and you cook it until it gets all brown, and add a bunch of salt to it. And then grab some frozen peas, and frozen peas are delicious easy to make.
Yes.
You can just throw them in with your pasta, like the last
full
couple
of
minutes.
Country goodness and green peas.
Which will thaw them and cook them a little bit, because you know peas technically take almost no time at all to cook. So like the last 5 minutes or something like that, just throw in a handful or a lump of frozen peas if you roll like I do. So then you have, like, we'll say some kind of pasta. We'll say probably macaroni. You got macaroni and peas. And then you... I'm working on it. Brown, have you guys not heard of brown butter sauce? Then toss...
Apparently I missed one when I was here before.
So, drain your peas and pasta, and then pour in your...
How many times did I walk past that one? Like a bajillion? I thought that prompt was for opening the gate.
Then toss your pasta and peas into your brown butter sauce. And taste it and see if you need any more salt and pepper and stuff like that. Other seasoning you could do is you could do some fresh basil if you had it. That would be really good. Basil and brown butter. Mmm. You could do sage if you like sage. I really like sage. Not many other people do, so I'll recommend that you stick with basil. Toss in some green onions. You get real fancy. And then toss in and then cut up some hot dogs into like small pieces, not like chunks of wiener, but like cut them in half and like maybe into quarters and stuff like that, so you can get a few pieces of wiener and like peas and some pasta together, and then toss that all together so everything's covered in this delicious like brown butter sauce with salt and pasta and peas and delicious. And then just eat your canned peaches for dessert. It's Pinoy spaghetti, says Jay. Is that, like, Filipino spaghetti? Pinoy, I've only ever heard in reference to Filipino cuisine. If I don't know anything about Wanajun, if you like sage, skip that basil thing and get a few leaves of sage and kind of, like, smash them together in your hands to get the oils out of them, and, cook them in your butter so your butter's infused with sage. So good. Beets.
Aha.
Beets, sausage, and pineapple.
Beets by Dre.
Mm-hmm.
Oh. Of course there's one in there.
Zaland, some kielbasa and rice. Oh, just make some Creole-style dirty rice. Literally spice it up. Get some chili powder and stuff like that. Delicious.
The other way.
Beets, sausage, and... Like, do you mean sausages or sausage meat? What the heck is London Broil? It's capitalized. I assume it's a brand? Sweet. Honestly, let's assume you have sausages and not like breakfast sausage meat. I would toss your. I would brown your sausages in like. You fry, like, to cook sausages, you fry them up in a pan until they're brown on the outside, but then they're not going to be cooked all the way through. Oh, it's a specific cut of steak. Okay. Oh, Lord Zerka, all you have is cheesecake, you eat the cheesecake. And
how am I supposed to get up there?
I have no idea. I recommend you eat the pineapple for dessert. I'm not a big fan of just throwing in something that's really sweet.
Wow, I can jump?
Like a fruit that's almost exclusively the flavor profile of sugar into a dinner. Like, just eat it for dessert. Like, peaches and pineapple and stuff can be really good in food, but like, as part of a salsa or something, but if you do not have the rest of the ingredients, I do not know how to make Asian beef. So maybe go out and buy a zucchini.
All the data we've compiled.
And
that looks
God,
like the last
Lord willing, an onion.
Boss, get back to the
and
mission.
Cut your zucchini into large pieces.
Got all patches. Completing mission.
Yay! Cut your beet into smaller to medium pieces, and cut your onion into whatever size pieces you like, depending on how much you like onion. And then prep your sausages in a pan till they're sort of crispy on the outside. And then take like a glass baking pan, and then dump all that delicious sausage fat, I'm not even kidding, onto your vegetables, because you probably won't that much. If you're watching your health, maybe do a couple of tablespoons. And this is for all the vegetables you're cooking. Just give them some flavor. Season them up with a little bit of salt and pepper. I'm a big fan of salt and pepper. Roast them in the oven until the vegetables are done. They'll bring out the delicious sweetness of the beets. The sausage grease will add some flavor to the zucchini, but it'll also pick up stuff from the beet and the onion. And then you can throw your sausages in there to cook, and it will be delicious. And then it'll be like oven-roasted tasty vegetables. And basically, how do you know it's done? When you can stick a fork into your beet. That's what I would do.
Now it's time to get to the chopper. Hurry up, Morpo.
Now, if you have sour cream and pasta and, like, a beef, you could make homemade stroganoff pretty easily if you just add a bunch of mushrooms. Yeah, a sweet demi-glaze is a good way to use fruit in a main course, but why would you, like, you're not gonna glaze your hot dogs in peach, right? And sausage and pineapple don't exactly go together.
Man, Morpho's taking a sweet time. Hurry up, buddy.
This is Morpho.
Oh, wait, I can give you, now I've given you a bunch of, like, good cooking recipes. Here's a bad cooking recipe that my dad taught me and I love it. And I make this when I'm feeling particularly, like, more comfort food. You have ground beef. You have a tin of mushroom soup. You have some sour cream. Maybe you don't. I hope you do. You have some pasta. Should be egg noodles. Maybe just macaroni. Cook your noodles. While that's going, fry up your ground beef. Drain your ground beef. Add your tin of mushroom soup. Stir it together to make a ground beef mushroom soup slurry. Slap in like as much sour cream as you want. And then stir your noodles into that. You have the world's grossest, according to cooking people, stroganoff.
Why did you fly over them all? There's nobody at those guns. Barely anyone's awake. Looks like we got away with it.
Yeah, but the thing is, okay, if you're watching Chopped is fantastic, but Chopped assumes that you have a lot more ingredients than most people have on hand, and they're asking you to do fancy stuff, right?
Whatever.
I really like Chopped.
Whatever Jada's doing.
This is more for the desperation chef is what I'm going for. I don't know how to do this. I don't want to spend a half an hour doing something I've never done.
There was
before.
No one to shoot, Chemical. Oh, still loading.
No kidding, Chopped is redonked. Chopped is fantastic if you already have a lot of stuff on hand or you already kind of know how to cook. Like, I really know, and I really know what they're trying to do. But, like, this is, like, I'm hungry, and this is what, I feel that there's room for that kind of cooking instruction. Yeah, Goodies Snake. Is amazing. I've not seen Cutthroat Kitchen.
Snake!
Medic!
Oh, you have a medic. That's good.
She's rigged. Damn it, we were set up!
We gotta get it out. No time for anesthetic. We have to open her now.
Ugh.
Wait, what's going on?
She's got a bomb.
Hold
what?
Her down.
They have sewn a bomb into her?
Looks like it. They said she's rigged. And they don't have time for anesthetic, apparently.
No.
Oh, this is very detailed.
No! I don't want to watch this.
Well, don't watch it.
I'm not. I'm looking away.
Good. It's just suddenly it turns into Surgeon Simulator. That would be the worst.
That can get fucked.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it could even spaghetti fucked.
She's handling the pain quite well. It's a good thing pain's an illusion. Good point.
No, lunchtime's an illusion. No, time's an illusion, lunchtime doubly so.
Keep her gun in!
This is impressive.
Did the Americans do this to her?
No, it's a bunch of horrible things. That would be super painful. Yeah. Jesus, that's huge!
Breathing stable, no active bleeding. She's clean, I'm closing her up. Hold her steady. It's gotta be a continuous suture.
Control tower, this is Morpho 1.
That thing was massive!
What's up, Huey?
Our guests are right on time. Document destruction and hangar decontamination are complete. AFVs have been stowed away, and Zeke's on the seafloor along with a nuke. Everyone's got their story straight. The guided tour will be wrapped up by the time you get home.
That's Otacon.
By the time they leave, I'll have the IAEA praising us as the poster boys for world peace. Out.
Wait, they still got the same guy to do the voice? So Huey, I guess, because again, I mentioned I hadn't played Peace Walker. I guess Huey has the same voice as Hal Emmerich. They got him back, but they replaced David Hayter with Keith. I don't understand. It is Huey Emmerich? That's what I thought. Of course it's his father. Of course it is. Mother Base has seen better days. I assume this is Mother Base.
Look! Commander Miller!
I know, I want to play Peace Walker, but I just never got around to it on the PSP. Uh-oh. This is pretty intense here. Ooh, rough. That base looked like it was big once. I guess if everyone knows where this massive army that doesn't have a country is moored, they can just come and wreck you.
Inspection is nothing but a smoke screen.
He's okay. I heard
explosions. If that is true, the GTF, I'd also be pretty annoyed, because...
They played us like a damn fiddle!
Hater seemed pretty ticked off.
This isn't right, that was ours! We built it, dammit! You spy bitch! Come on, start talking, bitch! Come on, get up and start talking!
Miller, she's been through some shit. How is she standing?
You little...
Bob, there's...
It's all right, we got it out.
There's another... in my...
Sucks to be Paz.
Did she just get shot?
No. Oh! That's also bad. I assume it was in her head, so. Why have two bombs when you can have just one well-concealed bomb? Well, I guess because then you're like... I guess because, you know, they're like, aha, a bomb! We got it. Everything is fine.
Well, they put a second bomb there?
But their death served as a message to others. That ours is a society that murders the innocent.
Ours is a society. That was very well enunciated.
Do you too believe your sacrifice will change the world?
Oh, because they got him to do facial capture as well. What's wrong with that? David Hayter can do facial capture. Oh yes, I forgot. Skull face.
Wow. Apparently, hey, Graham. Apparently,
wait. Hideo? There's a character called Hideo? I missed that completely. What's up?
Oh, nothing. It's not important. I'll tell you later.
Okay. I'm playing a game right now.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, cool. Nicola and Bart. Hideo was in one of the side missions. So he's in his own game now? So there's... You guys said there's like five other little sort of side mission-y things? We're about the time when we would ordinarily be wrapping up, but we will we'll take a quick look at one of those missions and see what sort of content they have.
Oh, I was going to compliment you for wrapping up quickly.
Oh, I'm sorry. We'll just take a sec. I didn't think you were going to be sticking with me.
I figured I brought you dinner so late.
Yeah, I'm super excited for Phantom Pain as well. I mean, I like any kind of Metal Gear game, so obviously I'm going to dig it. Persedge, it's only $20 if you download it. And it's probably even cheaper in the States. Like I said, it's only $40 in Canada, because those are Canadian dollars, and that's what games cost in Canada. A new release is $70 here, so balance that out. I'm not sure what it is in the States. I think it's $30. That's the story mission. There's other missions. To you if you want to buy it or not. I mean, I'm sorry. I know that that's a cop-out just to be like, well, if you don't want it, don't buy it, but whatever. I'm happy with it. So. Oh, Noxo Chills. The Metal Gear Acid games were fantastic. Big fan of those. Yeah, in the States on PlayStation Network, it's $20. There you go. It's fine. I don't assume I can skip this. 3D scanning. Oh, good tip there, Haunted Technician. Thank you. Yeah, Metal Gear Acid is an alternate universe also. It's basically unrelated to all of this, but it's a lot of fun. They're also very different games. They are tactical card games. I know that sounds weird, but I really enjoy them.
What's Metal Gear Acid for?
PSP. Invisible Queen, that's a terrible joke. Yeah, they're a lot of fun. J. Pratt Phoenix says, and I learned about pork chops thanks to Kathleen. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Bum 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 bum. Ooh, credits for the manual. That's unusual. Packaging design.
God, how many... have you been watching this? for like.
This is the.
Graham, you've been watching these credits for 6 minutes.
Okay. I can't skip them, sorry.
That was just ridiculous.
You can turn the actual. The normal cover. You can turn the normal cover inside out, and you get this sweet one with the big Ashley Wood art. Also, where's the case for Final Fantasy? Final Fantasy's in here for now. I mean, the credits are this long because they're doing kind of, frankly, cool stuff like crediting the people that made their website or the designed the packaging, which is very unusual. The GTF, it totally depends on if you like the gameplay or not, and I thought the game, like, I like the Metal Gear Solid universe and everything, but the gameplay in Metal Gear Acid I thought was really cool.
Cypher's been in hiding ever since his grand experiment. No one's seen him in years.
Ba-ba-bum.
All we hear are orders delivered by proxy.
Ah.
Except you. You met with him, face to face, in order to contact Big Boss. Tell me where he is. Where is Cypher? Where is Zero? I've never known choice. Where I was born, the language I speak, I've never had the freedom to choose for myself. But you, right now, are free. Do as you will.
This will save Big Boss.
It may.
Will you really kill Zero for me?
What did Zero do that got someone so pissed off?
All right. Zero is...
Like, Zero was your handler in Snake Eater. Also, something, something, Guns of the Patriot, something, something. Don't want to get too far into that. And now, a brief history of the Cold War. this is hell, all right, yeah. No, it's beyond the Cold War. That is an awkward 2008 there.
What happened?
It says that the American president vows to close Guantanamo Bay. No, I didn't forget MGS4. I was just saying also MGS4 or something, something. I just wasn't going to get into the end game spoilers of MGS4. Ooh. Neat. Uh-huh. Ah. Uh-huh. Ooh. Uh-huh. I see. What? Loading. The thrill of loading. Operation Deja Vu looks pretty sweet. Oh. He's had better days. Recreate the strangely familiar scenes shown in photographs and head for the goal. I just want to find out what this is, and then I'm probably going to pack it in for the evening. But it looks like there's enough stuff here to keep me entertained next week as well. So we'll probably do more Ground Zeroes, do like the side missions and general tomfoolery next week. And then probably the week after, I don't know. Might do some Deus Ex. Foxmar gave me Deus Ex in the Fall, which I might check out. And because I love Deus Ex. It's really, really good.
What's Deus Ex in the Fall?
It was an iOS game that got ported to PC. I'm freaking out.
Boss, I've uploaded some photos to your iDroid. Use them as clues to find the locations they show and recreate the scenes they depict. We're counting on you, Snake. Commence Deja Vu mission. A chopper and two sentries. A box and lights. A surveillance camera with a green light. Huh. Where could it be? A soldier and a tank? A car. Huh. The last photo's missing. Oh, sorry. I forgot it. Snake, it should be on the back of the disc case. Or what about the manual? There's gotta be a clue somewhere.
Of course. Of course. Yep.
What?
Just this. This is like nostalgia mission. It's fantastic. This is worth the price of admission, as far as I'm concerned. What? Look, it's the old Foxhound logo.
Shadow Moses Island, a remote island off the coast of
Alaska. Oh, whoa! They've made the first level of Metal Gear again? Like the first Metal Gear?
Not really. Like this is the same usual, level.
This is a one-man infiltration
mission. All I saw was Alaska, and I was
equipment,
like, that's
OSP. This is a top secret black op.
There's nothing on the box that I can tell right now. Although he did say maybe in the manual. They'd have to do it in the manual because if someone buys it digitally. Also, there's no physical manual. Yeah, it's that. So do I have to take these pictures? How do I do this?
Almost there.
Oh, I also am being
from the scene if you're spotted and being pursued by the enemy. Be careful.
I also have, right, weapons and equipment OSP, of course. Man, the old music! Yeah, Lone Bard, I've actually talked about that before. The Legacy Collection doesn't have that. They didn't reduce the resolution, but they definitely messed with the color palette. And the saturation. So yeah, I'm obviously not able to do this right now. But... try that one more time. Oh, it's not raining also. Yeah.
Snake, talk to me! Snake!
Not until you turn on the weather control system.
Yeah. Alright, I'm gonna get one of these pictures so I can see what the hell is up with this.
As clues. Find the locations they show and recreate the scenes in the photos. We're counting on you, Snake.
CP, this is Zulu 4. We'll investigate ASAP.
Out. Is that it? It's not right. There's something missing.
I need the other guard.
It's not right. There's something missing.
Do I have to, like, lead the other guard over there? I don't have any... don't have any magazines.
That sounds annoying.
It's not right. There's something missing.
Hmm. Oh, I see. For this one, I have to actually go and move this spotlight, or it's not accurate. Oh, I see. Interesting.
Almost there.
I think that's what I have to do. Anyway, that's cool. I dig it. All right. I'm gonna take off. But we'll do more of this next week. This I'm excited about this. And just generally messing around. We've done all the plot stuff, got that out of the way. Now we can just do other cool random things. So, looking forward to that.
It's time for the time-honored video game skill of fuck-aroundery.
Exactly. The time-honored skill of fuck-aroundery. So, gonna take off for now. But thank you guys for watching and joining me for that this evening. I had a lot of fun. I hope you did as well. And we will do more of that next week. And no promises, but there may be something going on Sunday. Keep an eye on the calendar. The streaming. There might be a streaming thing going on Sunday. Keep an eye on the calendar. Until next time, see you guys later.
Goodbye, everybody. Okay.
Goodbye.